mule deer are a profoundly intelligent animal. They, in fact, may have pound for pound the largest brain of any deer in the world. And we see them being identified in some way by their curiosity. Raggedy Ann's daughter, Ragtag, was also a breakthrough deer. She allowed me to touch her, of course, but the phenomenal thing with Ragtag was that she was the first deer to actually groom me in return. Mule deer do not randomly groom one another. It is something that occurs within the family. And I realized suddenly, I had this revelation that, oh, this deer thinks of me as one of her family members.
What is it? You need more scratching. You need more scratching.
It's phenomenal, and it's actually quite an honor to be included like that.
Babe, look here.
When getting close to other animals, I've always tried hard to never use my human voice. But with these mule deer, I immediately recognized they were somehow acknowledging their names and responding appropriately.
Blossom.
I call, and they instantly look up.
Come here, Blossom.
And perhaps slowly amble over to my side. Of course, deer don't understand a human language, but without doubt, they derive meaning from the context and tone of my words. Dogs have been bred for thousands of years to pay attention in this way. But such traits in a wild mule deer are a mystery. What evolutionary advantages can there be in this ability?